Well, back out here at the golf course this morning. Let's walk over here and see how bad our trench is. That's a little wet. Got a little stream flowing through there. That's what I wasn't too worried about. Finished grading that. I'm gonna have to go out here and build me a little cofferdam. Dig all that mud out. Put some dry dirt back in there. Get that tracked in. All right, well, let me build a little cofferdam, set up the laser, and we'll go ahead and get the area cut out for the box to sit and lay the pipe, go ahead and backfill it with dirt.
disappear quick. Here we go. As I knock dirt in the trench I just dug. I'm gonna set, yeah, gotta get the woman out of the bow first. So we got one that we already cut the bell off of. This will be the second one. Do-to-do, keep spinning, keep spinning. Keep spinning. back it in. I've got to put enough dirt where I can reach through the 4-inch drain pipe coming out from over there. I've got to extend that out. I can't quite reach it just yet. I'm going to fill this in, that way I can drive a little closer.
Got our box set, pipe is put in here all the way down to right there. I'm going to go ahead and backfill that up, and we got the compactor for the mini and the jumping stack. Go ahead and pack that in place.
I'm laying the last of the dirt in here, then we got to haul in the rest, which we got a spot not too far away we can get dirt from. We'll have to dump it out and I have to load it into the little dump wagon behind the tractor and bring it over here. placed it over here. It won't be nobody's problem.
So we got all our clay put in here that I was able to dig up for that borrow pit that was right here. So you can see how much dirt we are short. Got that packed in there with the sheep's foot compactor. What I got to do now is bring dirt from across the fairway. There's a lot of irrigation lines out here and we don't want to damage the road. So I got to load it into the little dump trailer and bring it over here. It shouldn't be too terribly bad, but instead of being able to back the loaded dump truck across here, we're just afraid it's going to tear up too much. So we're going to load that in there and I can bring it over here. And I should be able to get all that dumped out and packed in before he gets back with another load. We probably need about 5 truck loads. Still hauling dirt. He just dumped load number three out. I've hauled probably almost one and probably three quarters of the second load over here. I'm gonna jump on the 160 now and take this dirt and rake it out across there and get all that packed in before I dump too much and the lift is too big. So it's coming along. I'd say that's probably 2 yards every little wagon load. Maybe, it's at least two, maybe two and a half. Six full bucketfuls with the mini. It's actually pretty impressive what that little trailer would do. If it had some size, it's got no problem picking that up. If it had some boards on the side, you could probably put another two scoops in there and a tailgate, but you have to get out there and manually release that every time, and that would get a little old, so. All right, let's rake this out. Well, it's coming along. About two more lifts right there and some more right in here, especially in that corner right there, but getting everything put in place. And we got to raise this up just so it never floods over right here. We're going to raise it up enough where if it does overfill that box, it'll run around the fairway over there is what they want, so it doesn't ever possibly wash this out. It'll flood across here about 3 or 4 inches deep and not wash anything, and just it's so flat it'll just be nice and gentle across there, and shouldn't erode anything, because he says when they have a humongous rain, this creek over here floods and it just all this is underwater. So it's not like it's going to be a huge problem if a little bit extra flows across the fairway, but it shouldn't happen very often with that big pipe. All right, so we got about 50 bags of concrete mixed and pour around there. Got a bag of bentonite just for extra protection. I'm gonna go ahead and backfill this box and start putting dirt in here and building this bank back. Fun starting to fill up too. And now everything is done. So got this raised up right here so that this is higher than the spillway area right here. So water is actually starting to back up already. Got some groundwater, probably the runoff from when they irrigate. But we got the new riser box set in place and 60 feet of pipe ran through here, filled in the old spillway. They're gonna come back in here and dump topsoil and grade over everything and sod everything. So I just got this clay spread out and tracked in. And the pipe discharges right here into the existing creek channel. And we extended that little 4-inch pipe out, so should be good to go now. Come over here with the tractors and drag around and plant some grass and probably roll some sod out, I mean. And about 3 or 4 weeks, you probably won't even be able to tell that we've been here. Time to load up, head off to the next one.